Hello everybody, today we are going to see our next concept, okay, from area of parallelogram and triangles. Okay, this is the second concept and we are going to see some theorems. Okay, so from that second theorem is triangles on the same base and between the same parallels are equal in area. Okay, we have seen one important theorem: parallelograms on the same base and between the same parallel are equal in area. Now here we need to prove triangles on the same base and between the same parallels are equal in area. Okay, so what is given here? See, triangles are given ABC and PBC. Okay, both the triangles are on the same base BC and between same parallels BC and AP. That is given according to the question. Triangles are given. So first we need to mention here given. What is given? Two triangles ABC and PBC on the same base, which is same base BC. Okay, so here we can write BC and between the same parallels, between same parallel lines BC and AP. Okay, BC and AP, understood. And what we need to prove? To prove here area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle PBC. Okay, so this is our target, this we need to prove, understood. So for this we need to do some construction. We need to construct two parallelograms. Okay, with the help of parallelogram we are going to prove this. Okay, so what is construction, which construction we are going to do? We are going to take a parallel line here which will be parallel to PC. Okay, so suppose BD I'm taking here BD. Okay, BD will be this point, I'm saying here D. So this is BD parallel to PC. Okay, also from this point we need to take a parallel line which will be the parallel to AB. Okay, so that I'm taking here. So now we will mention, this is suppose D, this I'm saying Q. Okay, so here APBC, and now we will mention through B, draw BD parallel to PC, intersecting AP at point D, understood. Same thing, and again through C, draw CQ parallel to AB intersecting AP at point Q. Okay, so this is Q point. So this construction we have done. Okay, now we will move towards the proof. Okay, what is proof? Proof will be, we need to think about quadrilateral. See, BCQA. Okay, everybody getting BCQA and BCPD. Okay, BCQA is also a parallelogram. Okay, BCQA, because by construction AB and CQ is parallel, understood. As well as BCPD, here DB and PC are parallel. Okay, so both the quadrilaterals which we got here, both the quadrilaterals are parallelogram. Okay, so reason, what is the reason behind this? We can say by construction, understood. So that I am taking here quadrilateral BCQA is a parallelogram, understood. Why? By construction. What is the reason? By construction. Okay, again we can say quadrilateral BCPD is also a parallelogram. Okay, here also the same reason by construction. Okay, then if parallelograms are on the same base and between the same parallel, okay, see here both the parallelogram, this and this, so we can say parallelogram BCQA and parallelogram BCPD are on the same base and between the same parallels, between the same parallel. So what we can say, both are on the same base and between same parallel. So if parallelograms are on the same base and between same parallel, then area of both the parallelograms are equal, that we have seen. Okay, so from this we can say area of parallelogram BCQA is equal to area of parallelogram BCPD. Okay, so both the parallelograms are equal in area. Understood? Now what we can say, now CA is diagonal. See, CA is the diagonal of ABCQ. Okay, CA is the diagonal of ABCQ. Okay, so here I am taking that CA is diagonal of parallelogram ABCQ. Understood? Or BCQ also we can say, that is on this side. Okay, so ABCQ. So area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle AQC. ABC and AQC is equal because diagonal bisects the parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Okay, so ABC and AQC will be same. So is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABCQ. Okay, this triangle is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABCQ. Okay, so this is our, here we will mention this is second thing and this we will say first thing. Okay, because afterwards we are going to use this. Now what we can say here, PB is the diagonal of DPCB or BCPD. Okay, PB is the diagonal of BCPD. So definitely due to PB, this parallelogram is divided into two congruent triangles. Okay, whose areas will be equal. So here I am taking that area of triangle PBC is equal to half of parallelogram BCPD. Okay, so this is I am saying here third one. Okay, so now after this, here we said here both the parallelograms are equal, ABCQ and BCPD are equal. Understood? So if ABCQ is equal to triangle ABC and BCPD is equal to PBC, so from second and third we can say, or from first, second and third we can say area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle PBC. Okay, what did everybody, these two areas of parallelogram are equal, this and this is equal, so definitely it's another side or LHS are equal, ABC and PBC are equal. Okay, so this is one important theorem which we have studied now. Okay, so see carefully and solve the same theorem in your notebook. Okay, theorem number 3 is the area of a triangle is half the product of any of its sides and the corresponding altitude. Okay, what is given? See, once again, the area of a triangle is half the product of any of its sides and the corresponding altitude. Okay, so first we will see this figure is given. So given we will mention a triangle is given, a triangle ABC in which AL is the altitude. AL is the altitude. Okay, AL is the altitude to the side BC. To the side BC. Understood? What we need to prove? To prove area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC is equal to what is given? The area of triangle is half the product. Half the product. What is the product of any of its sides and the corresponding altitude? Okay, any of its side means any side we can take, but the altitude should be corresponding to that side. But now here we have taken side BC, so BC multiplied by corresponding height is AL. So this is we need to prove. Understood? So now proof, we will move towards the proof. Okay, but before that we need to do some construction. What is we need to do? We need to draw a parallel line from point C. Okay, parallel line. And here, from here also. Okay, suppose this point I am saying here D. So what is our construction? In construction, through C and A, draw lines parallel to BA and BC. Parallel to BA and BC. Okay, see, from C we have taken a parallel line which is BA, means BC, sorry, CD is parallel to BA and AD is parallel to BC. Okay, so that construction we have done. So intersecting at point D. Okay, so both the parallel lines which we have constructed are intersecting at point D. Okay, so now we will see about proof. Okay, so quadrilateral ABCD. Now see here, ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Why it is parallelogram? By construction. We have done construction. Constructed two sides which are parallel to the given side. So ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here we can say area of triangle ABC. This is now diagonal. AC is the diagonal, and diagonal divides parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Okay, congruent triangles means areas are equal. Okay, so we can say area of triangle ABC is equal to half of area of parallelogram ABCD. Okay, ABC and is equal to ADC. Both the areas will be equal, or sum of these two triangles areas is equal to parallelogram. So we can write area of triangle ABC is equal to half of area of parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so that we have done here. Now we can see here BC is a side of parallelogram BCDA and BCD or ABCD. BC is the side of parallelogram ABCD and AL is the corresponding height. Okay, so now we can see here, this is first one. Now we can see here corresponding height. Area of parallelogram ABCD. What is the area of, how to find out area of parallelogram? Base into height. Okay, so what is base? Here we can say base is BC multiplied by, we can say height is AL. Okay, height is AL. Okay, so here also we have parallelogram, half of parallelogram ABCD, and here area of parallelogram ABCD is equal to BC into AL. Okay, so this place, suppose we will put area of triangle ABC is equal to half of parallelogram ABCD. Okay, but area of parallelogram ABCD is equal to BC into L. So this we will put here. Okay, so we can say now area of triangle ABC is equal to this half multiplied by area of parallelogram ABCD is BC into AL. Okay, so this was the target, and that we have given proof for the same. Okay, so area of triangle ABC is equal to half into BC into AL. Area of triangle ABC is equal to half into BC into AL. Okay, so this was the second or third important theorem. Okay, so solve this theorem in your notebook.